doctor has to open up again and straighten you one more time. So you don't need repeated surgery. What's the problem? Material scientists. The problem is, what's the composition of this element? It's made of 50% nickel, 50% titanium. Nickel is toxic. It's a bad element. You put that in the human body, people get sick, inflammation. What a shame. You have something so good, but you cannot use because this is toxic, poisonous. From a scientist's point of view, can we do something about that? Can we block the out diffusion of nickel by putting on something on the surface so the nickel cannot go up? Can we? Yes, we can. Plasma technology. We use plasma implantation to implant oxygen and nitrogen. So basically, if you look at this, that profile, after you have implanted oxygen, because this is a two-phase system, oxygen has to react with somebody. So it will react with titanium, with a stronger bond. Nickel is depleted, so nickel is being pushed back. Okay? I made an analogy this morning when I talked. You know, it's very interesting to me anyway. Suppose you have two boys in the same room. No problem, right? They were good friends. Suddenly, with a beautiful girl coming in, what's going to happen? The stronger boy will kill the other one, right? Just like a lion. Right? Just like this case. You have nickel and titanium, two elements, and they have oxygen coming in. Who's going to stay? The one that has a stronger bond with oxygen. So that means that the stronger lion will fight. What happened to the nickel? Pushed away toward the end, like the other boy. Too bad, you're not strong. So that girl will go with the strong boy. Here, oxygen combined with titanium, you have a titanium oxide layer on the surface. Nickel is pushed away. So that's very nice. But now you have something that blocks the nickel. Nickel is no longer on the surface, but this is very thin. It's so thin, it doesn't affect the mechanical property of the material. It still can bend, it still can do that. Very, very nice. Now you get the point. This is the material science. You play, and you find something else. So we have to do some tests. This is our concept. So basically we say, okay, can we, after we have done the implantation, can we compare the corrosion resistance? This is an accelerated test. Untreated, a lot of hole, because nickel comes out, a lot of corrosion. With the coating, or not the coating, the implanted surface, very nice, because the surface is very strong. This is titanium oxide, the ceramic material. So you have nothing coming out. Chemically, we did some immersion tests, looking at how much nickel actually comes out. In the control sample, 30 parts per million, out diffused to the outside. But for our sample, negligible, almost nothing. So our layer is successful in impeding the out diffusion of nickel. So the next one, we have to do some animal tests. So we put this thing into a rabbit, a poor rabbit. We put this thing into the bone here, and then after a while, we take the materials out and see how the cell grows on the surface. From comparison, this is the carbon implanted, oxygen implanted, very, very good. The red part is a good cell. The white is the not good one. So this is untreated, not good. This is the treated, very nice. Let me have some water. I've been talking too much. There's no microphone. So animals only one thing. The next thing is, can we demonstrate that into human being? Without that, it's not useful. And we have. This is last summer. This is a very poor girl in southern China in Guangzhou. Okay, so we went to the hospital to look for patients. So this girl suffered from a young girl, about 14 years old. Usually it happened to have a young girl. And look at the back. It's a little bit strange. If you bend over, you can see the very severe position. And you can look at the spine. It's not very good. Okay? So we decided to use our material to work on the girl. Right? And the girl agrees because she got it free. She didn't have to pay, but she has to risk. But that's another thing. So we put our materials in the girl, and this is the after surgery. Everything is fine. So the spine is the back side of the back. It's very nice, straight. On the side, from here, you can see the curvature, you can see the pins, very terrible, right? But that's how it looks with the surgery. The doctor can knock this thing in just like wood.
Right. And this is our material, right here. Perfect collection. And this has been a year and a half now. And the girl is very good. Walked home to school and everything. And after that, we have done about 10 more cases. Everything is a success so far. And we'll do 200 more. After that, we'll go for a commercial product because it takes a big database. For biology, it takes a long time to check your connection and everything. Okay, with that, you know, this is about time to finish up our moments now. I'll just give some example on classroom-based applications. Only a small part of that, we do a lot more. It's very visible in microelectronics, nanotechnology, and biomedical sciences. And last but not least, I want to thank all my collaborators, including Professor Yang, Professor Wang, Professor Li, everybody here. Without the collaboration and the help, none of these would be possible. And last, I'm holding a conference in Hong Kong in year 2010. It's a nanoelectronic conference. We're going to look at nanofabrication, electronics, photonics, all beautiful Hong Kong. Better here than Beijing. At least today. And this has a lot of good speakers. We have a Nobel laureate, Harry Cole coming in. We have Charlie Lee from Harvard, Bai Chunli, Yuan Shi, and also 18 more Yuan Shi, Wang Zhangbo, Zhang Zi, also Vice President, who will be here. And hopefully you want to join. I have some brochures here, Professor Yang will give you some. And by the time you have some papers, we will appreciate it. Thank you.
刚才说的那个，在那个人体液里边放那个硅片，曾经不是产生那个钙吗？